Children, and it was very fascinating for me to listen to him about to define ourselves, how we can define ourselves. And still, you know, I'm trying to define myself, especially in my field in architecture. Last night, Aydin called me provide a sort of lecture, sort of discussion. So I'm trying to find something to share with you. The main topics of my discussion is how we can learn from ourselves. آموختن از خود. به عنوان یه معمار اگه از من بپرسید اوضاع معماری ایران چجوریه، من به شما میگم که اوضاع معماری فعلی ایران، اوضاع معماری کشور ما بسیار دور از معماری و دور از معماری ایرانی است. هیچ نشانی از معماری باستان، از معماری اسلامی و اساساً از معماری در ایران وجود نداره. در حال حاضر نیم قرنه که ما به کلی فاصله گرفتیم از معماری و اون چه که در نیم قرن اخیر ساخته شده ساختمانه و ساحت‌های پایین‌تر از ساختمان، مثل سرهمسازی، غلط‌سازی، قوطی‌سازی، بدسازی، ناپایدارسازی، و ما با تقلیل عظیم کمیت اجرا و کیفیت فضایی روبرو هستیم. Just as an observer in 50 years ago in Iran, what happened about our architecture, we just left the past and tried to construct. Only we have construction. There is nothing named architecture. Architecture as an art of space. So here I want to describe that as an architect, not only we are not happy with the architecture, here is architecture, of course. This building as a sort of exceptions among all constructions in Tehran. But this exception try to introduce some sort of creative approach to Iranian architecture. But this is exception, not the rule. The rule is construction. So the decrease, the huge decrease of quality and quantity in spatial organization, the present situation of our architecture in Iran. البته دلایل این بحث متعدده و ما میتونیم از دلایل اقتصادی، سیاسی، فرهنگی نامه بریم. من بیشتر رو دلایل فرهنگی میخوام متمرکز بشم و روی دلایل آموزشی. به طور اخص من میخوام بگم آموزش معماری در ایران مناسب نبوده و به عنوان فارغ التحصیل من در دانشگاه ملی درس خوندم، دانشگاه شهید بهشتی، سالهاست همینجا کار میکنم، ما آموزش مناسبی نداشتیم. Of course the reason why for defining the present situation why we are dealing with this kind of construction or spatial organization you can find many different reasons, economic, political, cultural. I'm focusing on cultural reasons and especially on educational system. As an architect studying in Iran, I confess that there is no appropriate architectural education in Iran. Not trying to understand the meaning of architecture and the meaning of Iranian architecture. So I try to study by myself. من شروع کردم برای خودم این موضوع رو بفهمم و در این میون متوجه یه چیزی شدم به اسم موسیقی ایران. I try to study by myself and meanwhile I found out that there is something equal to Iranian architecture is Iranian music. من آموختن موسیقی رو در حدود 30 سال پیش شروع کردم. در سیستم there is no player or artist. We have some master. Number 50 چهار پاره. Thank you.
by one word, I can guess, I can try to play whole melodies. So if you tell me, for example, number 24, Shekaste.
It's broken.
Yes, it means broken. Through this system, we learn how to modulate, how to combine different melodies, and based on these original melodies, we can improvise, we can develop the idea of different type of music. And you see, based on the names, which all now in Farsi, but for example, number 27 is Iraq. Iraq is Iraq. And is a part of, you know, our culture. So this type of reference system, it gathers the variety of cultures inside one type of system, which is music.
And the radical shift in philosophical core that has taken place. What is our understanding of our human purpose, our human the mind, our human relationships, and how has that radically changed? Because this shift from architecture to construction is not a random shift. It's a shift that has taken place because of very radical shift in philosophy and understanding of what the human endeavor is.
Right.
That's the core for me, is how, what is that shift in that endeavor that has taken place? Because then the form shifts, but what is our relationship with nature? Mm-hmm. You know, this is the core. So if we can try to get at that, I think it'll be a more interesting discussion, and try to get at something much more fundamental that has happened. And it has been, at least in my mind, it has been a very conscious decision has been taken to make that shift. Because it's not only a problem of Tehran, it's a problem of every major city in the world that is happening. So there is a desire to restructure human life and human relationship life. And what is the shift in the core that has happened in that? I think if we can talk about it before.
Why is that we are being conditioned, colonized by the Western aesthetic sense? And I began to explore this further. And I continued, and I started looking at books, I started reading. And finally, I started questioning that, how do we become the culture? You know, it's not that we are now, the problem with modern education is that we are being taught how to apply culture. You know, so if you want to make a house like this, then they should be Iranian. Suppose you want to, the same architect can go to India and create an Indian culture. You understand? So this is the problem with modern education. Modern education doesn't bring you out. And I feel that, and again I started exploring this whole confusion that Westerners created by terming things like art. You know, I find that this is all artificial.
Slow down the past.
نکته اساسی که اشاره میکنن میگن ما تو صحبتامون هم یه الان هنرم که مطرح میشه اینه که چطوری فرهنگ رو اعمال کنیم، نه اینکه فرهنگ رو چطوری زندگی کنیم. میگیم چیکار کنیم این خونه معماری ایرانی داشته باشه یا معماری هندی داشته باشه، مثل اینکه یه چیزی از بیرون باید طراحی بشه بیاد روش سوار بشه. توجه نمیکنیم که من چطوری زندگیش دارم میکنم. و این تقسیم بندی که توی آموزش مدرن هست که بین شاخه های هنر و علم و فعله تقسیم کنیم، یا دوستا رو همین اشاره کردم که ما یه مجموعه رو داریم تجربه میکنیم، داریم زندگی میکنیم، و این جداسازی مصنوعی گاهی اوقات ما رو از اون جدا میکنه و فکر میکنیم فرهنگ چیزی که باید بیاد ایجادش کرد. واژه فرهنگ سازی مثلا یا فرهنگی کردنش یا مثلا ایرانی کردنش، این رو یه تقسیم مصنوعی میکنه.
Yeah. So you know, I felt that what is very important is to recover your being, which is completely lost in the modern process of education. You are absent every time, you know? And I began to explore this, and I realized that, you know, one of the things I felt was that we need to recover our biological, you know, quality of knowing. You know, because we are, I don't think that knowledge is transmitted. Knowledge is created, recreated, reinvented. Each being is every time reinventing knowledge. So this transference of knowledge, which is a very Western idea, and also it was prevalent even in the East, that not, because, you know, Veda can be read and understood. People have read Veda and never understood. People who have experienced it, and many of them never read any Veda. You know, so I think it is about reliving, reclaiming, you know, using your being. That is important. And I have been,
It's about music, how it was transmitted without notes and without teaching. And it reminds me really that when we are read about the modern world, which is defined as subordinating living to education. Whenever we subordinate living to education, living is gone. That is, if we only transmit something via writing, written text, the text, and via teaching, it means we are killing the spirit. It is possible maybe to have that, not as a substitute, to make sure it is not substituting living. So this is, I think, a very good lesson for example, especially in Iran, how music, because everybody, it seems, in Iran is aware of this, that music has been transmitted not through schooling, not through education, not through texts, not through notes, but through living. And it is very important that we try to learn from the music in how we learn mathematics, science, language, literature, how to raise children, how to treat each other. It cannot be done through books. It has to be done through
This film is the only film he has made about children, and that's based on a personal experience from his own child. One of their teachers had taken a very difficult test, so one of the students who couldn't answer the test got mad and took the teacher's shoes and threw them out of the window. So. Says, I wish I could be as like this child who could show his protest somewhere. I was much more conservative when I was a kid. Says, as Milan Kundra says, sometimes in our stories and films, we try to portray those type of characters which we couldn't be ourselves. So. They asked about the names of the four narrative films, and the first one was called The Circle, which won the prize in the Cannes Film Festival in 1999, the Critics Award.
راجب یه پیرمردی بود که 70 سال دچار یک زندگی تکراری و بیهوده شده بود و توی دایره بسته زندگی گرفتار بود. یه روز تصمیم میاد پاشو از این دایره بزنه بیرون و بچگی کنه اونجوری که دلش میخواد.